Neutrinos are bad friends. They're hard to get a hold of, they barely interact with you, and when you try to plan their birthday, they'll claim they're way younger than you think. As it turns out, when you're a particle moving close to the speed of light, age isn't just a number. It's also a matter of your frame of reference. So how long can a neutrino live for? That is the topic for today's discussion on Even Bananas. There's a chance a nearly 14 billion year old neutrino from the Big Bang is passing through you right now. But if you were able to ask this neutrino how old it was, it would think it's much, much younger. So what is the actual lifespan of a neutrino? The short answer is, scientists don't really know. You see, some neutrinos are produced through radioactive decays, hang around for a bit, do some oscillating, and then at some point they interact and bam, they're gone. MUON neutrinos created at Fermilab interact with neutrons in our neutrino detectors, producing a proton and a muon. A neutrino came in, but none came out, so that neutrino is finito. But what about the majority of neutrinos that don't interact with other particles? Will they live forever? To help me answer that question, I've invited André de Gouvêa, a theoretical neutrino physics researcher and professor at Northwestern University.
Hi, Kirsty. This is a really interesting question. It's a fact that heavier particles will always decay into lighter particles as long as the rules of fundamental physics are obeyed. So for example, in the charged lepton family, there's the electron muon and tau, each with a different mass. The heavier tau and muons have relatively short lifespans, and they will ultimately decay down into the simplest, lightest charged lepton, the electron, plus a whole bunch of other light particles. When we talk about neutrino lifetimes, we have to think about neutrino mass states, not neutrino flavor states.
Quick review from our previous videos, the flavor states are our electron, muon, and tau neutrinos. The mass states are much less inventively labeled nu1, nu2, and nu3. In our neutrino oscillations video, you'll remember the mass states as beach balls. If you haven't seen that one, I'll link to it in the description. Each mass state has a mixture of all three flavor states, but it has a well-defined mass. We haven't measured what those masses are yet, but we know the differences between them, and we know that they're not zero.
Since we know neutrinos have mass, it stands to reason that the heavier neutrinos decay into the lighter ones. So let's assume that there are only two neutrinos, a heavy one and a light one. As long as there's mixing, the heavy neutrino will decay into either three copies of the lighter one or one copy of the lighter one in a photon. If our theories are right, it takes a really, really long time for the decay to occur. If you make a few assumptions about masses and mixings, we can calculate the lifetime and it's about 10 to the 40 years.
Which is many billions of times older than the age of the universe. You'd need a custom birthday card for sure.
So we don't worry about it. But we can also ask the opposite question. So experimentally, how much do we know about the neutrino lifetime?
That's a much harder question. Imagine measuring neutrinos from the sun. The fact that we measured them tells us that they didn't decay along the way. We know that light takes just over 8 minutes to reach us from the sun, and we know that these neutrinos travel nearly at the speed of light. So, can we say experimentally that the neutrino lifetime is at least 8 minutes?
Absolutely not.
Yeah. Through special relativity calculations, Einstein argued time is not the same for everyone. It depends on how fast you're traveling. If you travel closer to the speed of light, things get messy. It will seem to you like time slows down. This is known as time dilation. One example Einstein came up with to demonstrate this is the twin paradox. Fermilab's recent video with Don Lincoln on this topic is linked below.
At the speed we're traveling, it looks like neutrinos from the sun take about 8 minutes to get here. But since the neutrinos are traveling very close to the speed of light, in their frame of reference, it takes less than a millisecond. So according to the neutrinos, they're here in an instant. So the most robust knowledge on the neutrino lifetime suggests that they live more than a few milliseconds. One way to get more sensitive information is to experimentally measure neutrinos coming from much further away than the sun, such as a supernova explosion or the cosmic neutrino background. But the biggest challenge here is that even if a neutrino decays, it doesn't disappear. It probably just turns into another neutrino. So how do you tell those two apart? We still need to work out how to be sure we're measuring the original neutrino and not the one that showed up after the neutrino decay. We don't have that kind of resolution yet.
That sounds like a difficult but exciting problem to solve. Thanks, André. So there you have it. Neutrinos can likely live much longer than the age of the universe, but all we really know for sure is that it's longer than the time it takes for a fly to flap its wings, which makes it difficult to know how many candles are on your birthday cake. If you want to learn more about the long or short lives of these speedy neutrinos, be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more on our favorite fundamental particle. Fun fact, time dilation means that the faster you travel, the more time slows down. If you travel at the speed of light, time stops. Theoretically, if you could travel faster than the speed of light, time would go backwards. By working through the maths, antimatter, made of particles with negative mass, travels backwards in time.